Those who have gone before us have created a relationship with people that was one of integrity.
The fact that they worked hard, they prayed hard, they tried to respond to need.
To leave a penetrating presence among the people, if they feel and know themselves better and are a better person because we have cared for them in some way, I think that's one of the most important things.
We're not the only ones that have that spirit, but somehow Catherine McCauley, you know, she captured it and articulated it in different ways that have drawn us into it. But I know the employees in our health facilities and in the institutions, the other ministries that we sponsor, if they're the ones to carry on with our health system as we know it today, for example, I would be very proud.
There's something different in the co-workers and the people that are here. You know, they care for you, that compassion that is part of Catherine and part of Jesus to those that we touch.
Catherine began the formal works of mercy as a laywoman and with volunteers before she ever founded the community. And I think that's because she recognized that they were a part of what God was calling them to do, to serve others. And so I want the co-workers to understand that they're an integral part of continuing the mission and the ministry of mercy.
I think it's very exciting that we have masses of lay people who are so dedicated and so caring about what they do and how they do it.
It's not the big things, it's the little things that you do that make a difference in people's lives. And that's the legacy that I would like to see passed on, the love and concern for one another and for the people we serve.
Be true to yourself and the values that you hold, but realize that mercy is alive today in you, and we're dependent on that.